Hello, welcome to King of Europe. I am Mike from King of Europe.
Yeah, hello, my name is Dragan, and we'll show you how it looks like in a review of round 2 in Serres, Greece. This is the ultra fast racetrack. We have there very good weather and very strong Greek drifters. And Mike, who win in this round?
Katsanidis win in this round, like you can see the Alfa Romeo in his batting card against Anthony Plai.
Is this a whoop-whoop Plai?
Yeah, the Anthony Plai didn't win, but he catch the second place in the championship now.
Yeah, let's go next.
Yeah, let's go to Slovakia and see what's going on over there. So hello and welcome to King of Europe in Slovakia. I am with Norbert Kovacic, the local drift superstar. So welcome to Prešov. We are here for drifting and a lot more than drifting. Welcome to Slovakia. Welcome to King of Europe round 3. And we are arrived now for this round 3 in the nice city of Prešov. Not only Prešov, because Slovakia is a beautiful country. And this city, as you can see, has a very beautiful architecture. But like every King of Europe event, let's start in Friday night with the parade. And with this L Energy Drinks Camaro. This crazy Camaro of 600 horsepower, driven by the Hungarian drifter Pucci.
And who is this now, the youngest driver in Slovakia? Timo Štikar, 17 years old, drifter.
We have here, as you can see, a Polish invasion, a lot of Polish drifter. King of Europe is not only drifting, it's a lot of other activities. Like on Friday night you can see this concert, but we have a bit more than this concert on Friday night, but Dragan will tell you more about that kind of night.
Wow! Look this! Of course, the legendary Slovakian girls were there very nice and hot parties every night in Slovakia.
Yeah, I have very good memories of these parties, and Dragan also. But these kind of stories we cannot tell on television. We should focus on the drifting. We are here for King of Europe, for drift and for competition. So enjoy these nice pictures of the Slovakian girl, and let's go now in 1 minute to the competition. Thank you, girls. Now let's go drifting.
Hello, I'm Razvan Fatianu from Romania and it's BMW M3. Razvan last year was the best Romanian qualifier here. In Greece was the best qualifier also. So Razvan, what do you expect from us?
Hello, everybody. I'm very happy to be here in Prešov for the second time. As Mike said, last year I was the best Romania qualifier. I did okay. I'm hoping for good weather tomorrow, so cross fingers for tomorrow qualification. And if everything is okay, you'll see very good battles tomorrow, because here there are a lot of strong drifters from a lot of countries, a lot of new guys which we met. We made a lot of new friends, so in Prešov, as always, it's a very good atmosphere.
Okay, thank you, and all the best, Razvan.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you, all of you.
Okay, so we are with Pavel Kalotka from Poland. We have a lot of Polish drifters this weekend. Your first time in King of Europe, Pavel. Yeah. So give us your first impression about King of Europe.
It's a great opportunity to have fun, to make a lot of friends, and your drivers are very good. So yesterday there was no rain, so the track was really great. We can push the throttle to the limit and have a good time. Now there's a bit slippery, the track is very precise and the clipping zones are very wide, so everything is much worse, and we have to push throttle a little bit less. But your drivers from Slovakia are very good, so we have to manage them.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
Tomorrow's qualification, all the best. Thank you.
Hello, I am Roman Kolesa from Slovakia and it's BMW M3 E46.
And now I will show you one lap on the board.
Thank you.
Windows, check control water. Check control A. Start. First gear. Second gear. safe goal. Limburg. Goes. Full throttle. Always full throttle. Full throttle. Limburg. Full throttle. Always full throttle. Always full throttle. Finish.
Okay, as you can see, we are now on the start line area. Practice is over. It's time for qualification. One warm-up, three qualification. Only the strongest survive. Let's go for qualification and see you after.
Okay, let's go in qualification. First, Polish Verbicki and his Nissan S14 motorized by BMW V8 engine. For Verbicki is a 10th place in qualification. Okay, next one is Diego Guaranta from Italy. Fastest entry speed with telemetry, but more infos about telemetry and the end of this show.
Let me remind the nickname Il Gomaro, crazy burning tires man.
Yes, Gomaro.
So tell me the position of this Gomaro in qualification?
Yeah, his position is a 9.
Very good, very good, but it's a strong drifter. So now let's see Kereni. Kereni will get 8th position for this run. He is the boss. And let's see how it's going on. Very good line for slip. You can see the red flag. You can hear the sound of this 3.8 M5 engine. Not the fastest, but very good run. Kereni is strong in the battle. His 8th place is perfect for him. And now let's see Marco Blazuta and his M3 four doors. He's a very cool guy, very friendly driver. But on the track, there is no friend. He's very hard pushing. See his run, first slip is okay. Second clip. Also,
big smoke.
Oh yeah, big smoking. He brings 70 tires for Slovakia and Maria Poch. He's a crazy guy, and he will get 6th place. Goliatsevich is not impressive Polish drifter, but very, very effective. When we see the data of the telemetry, there is no doubt. You see the clip, you see the angle, you see the speed. 6th position for this guy. So now after this guy, let's review the top 5 of the qualification.
Yeah, let's go to see who is the next. Position number 5, Vartalovic, crazy Polish drifter. Very, very fast this weekend, and he have very, very good grip with this E30.
Yeah, very special tires that they bring from Poland. Max Core tires, something like that, but he's a fast, but on the video we see, but in the real is more impressive again, huh?
Yes, in the battles you will see how he can escape and how he can push.
Yeah, very, very good drifter. 5th position for this guy.
And now, military guy from Hungary. Who is that? Peter Porkola from Hungary, very technical drifters. And he's military, E30.
Yeah, very special composition. Very quiet guy, very shy guy, but behind the wheel is very technical, very good.
And he is in the 4th place in qualification.
We will see in battle how this guy is doing. And now Zoltán Kalin, 3rd place in qualification, 3rd place last year in King of Europe 2010. This is a Skyline with RB25, 600 horsepower engine. Crazy machine, devil machine. Look the line, look the sound, look the speed. Yeah, perfectly point. 3rd place for Kalin.
Kalin and the Graf Drift Team. Yeah, and now we watch Szabo Szilard from Hungary and the big but light Mercedes E500. Impressive car in battle. but also in qualification. Second place for him.
Yeah, Dragan, this car looks like a tank, but it's a big mistake. This car is not a tank. It's very light, look original, but inside it's a very professional car.
Also very good balance because engine is almost in the middle of the car.
Yeah, and the driver is very cool also. Good guy, good friend, Szabo.
And on the end, who is the best?
Yeah, the pole man, Gezatot, from Hungary again, with this E36 V8 engine. Crazy sound, and he's very good guy, Geza. Very cool guy also. That's the King of Europe spirit. Cool guy, cool competition, everybody's friend, everybody have good time. That's it.
Of course, Gezatot and very nice and impressive qualification lap for everybody.
We hope that he will have better luck than in Serbia, where he broke the clutch.
Yeah.
So now let's review qualification. You can see what we see on the track, we see in the rankings. Telemetry always give the good results. So that's it. Gezatot first, Szilard second, Zoltán third place. Now it's time for the best moment of the weekend, the battles.
Let's go in battles.
Final now, as you can see, big battles coming, but unfortunately the rain is coming also, so let's see what's going on. First battle, Kereni with Diego Quaranta from Italy, Il Gomaro. Tell me more about Gomaro and Kereni, Dragan.
Yeah, this is the first big battle in top 16, and BMW versus BMW, and the score is 7-3, 5-5 for Kereni.
Yeah, Kereni is very experienced in the wet. He won in Serbia on the wet also. And he's just following there, you can see, following easy Quaranta. And then when Quaranta follow, we'll take away, and that's it. Kereni will go to the top 8.
And now we watch a second battle. Roman Kolesar against Gezatot. Everybody expect, because Gezatot is the best qualifying guy. And we expect to Gezatot make easy this battle, but you will see what's happening now.
Yeah, Geza is a bit stressed, you can see, he tried to escape, but he cannot escape. You see Roman push and push again, and Geza wants to go to escape, he cannot, worst, oh, right at the
spin.
Yeah, Geza, this is top 16 and Geza is already out. Now let's go to already to top 8, this is the first quarterfinal, let's go.
Yeah, this is the first quarterfinals. This is a Szabo Szilard, and you see Mercedes against Vrbinski Nissan V8. And we see Szabo follow, but who escape?
Yeah, Szabo follow good, but in first leg he spin. So it's easy run now for Vrbinski. Just make sure that he don't spin. He's the leader. He win the round easy, and that's it. Vrbinski make it to the final four.
And now also big battle, E30 battle. It's Vartalovic Porkolab, fast guy against technical guy. But this time Porkolab can follow the Polish. Congratulations, Vartalovic.
Yeah, very technique, but on the rain we need the speed. And this Polish guy, like we said before, has a special Max Sports tire, and they are very fast on the wet. Even here, if he can follow easy, when Vartalovic been leader, he was putting like 5-6 car distance to the poor Porkolab. Anyway, we'll see Porkolab again in Maria Poch, and let's see now Vartalovic in the final four.
And now Kereni Kolesar.